buddy. FKT season might be over in the 14ers. I don't know if this snow is gonna melt. And I gotta turn around because it's just too deep. Like it's about 6 inches deep on the trail right there. So that's the trail right there. Anyway, oh man, but it's beautiful. Shoes are doing great. See you in the studio.
Well, that was interesting, everybody. I didn't do as much filming as I would have liked. It was beautiful up there. I didn't do much filming because I couldn't feel my fingers. I have 4 or 5 pairs of gloves, and I definitely should have grabbed my thickest gloves. I just was thinking, it's not December yet. It's not January. It's September. Oh, it was cold up there, but we survived. I don't know. FKT season in the 14ers of Colorado might be over for the year. Unless this melts in like the next week, I suspect we're gonna get another storm in the next couple of weeks, and so it might be over as far as going fast up on the 14ers. We will see. Okay, here we go. And yes, I'm drinking hot tea, just trying to warm up. Hold on here. All right, let's dive into it. Talking about a brand new trail running shoe from New Balance. Here we go. The Fresh Foam More V1 from New Balance. There it is over on the shelf. Okay, I'm liking the colorway, liking what they're doing with the midsole here. 4 millimeter drop, 33 millimeter stack height in the heel, 29 in the forefoot, by the way. Just my first impression, not my full review. You saw the unboxing in the car this morning. So 4 millimeter drop. Now, men's size 9, women's size 8, once again, I couldn't find, but men's size 9, here we go. I saw 10.8. I think that's a little high because my size is coming in at 9.7 ounces, which in my size is actually pretty good for a trail running shoe. Anything under 10 ounces is pretty solid for a trail shoe in my size. So there's my score for the weight of the Fresh Foam More Trail V1. And onto the upper of the Fresh Foam More, it's a double jacquard mesh upper with high breathability. In fact, maybe too breathable for winter conditions. If you live in northern Maine, or maybe it's Norway or Sweden, or I don't know, somewhere where it's cold, you might need to wear extra thick socks because I felt the airflow quite a bit through this toe box. As far as the tongue of the tongue, pretty thin actually. I'm a little surprised at how thin it was, but the lockdown wasn't impacted at all by that thin tongue. And yes, it is a fully gusseted tongue, so it's connected completely to that inner, the inside of the wall of the upper there. So nice work on the tongue. I like it. And as far as the heel counter goes, let's do the test here. Yeah, fairly stout, but it's got some give actually. Plush heel counter and collar, frankly, but not the tongue. It's interesting. I'm not sure why they decided not to do the tongue as plush as the heel counter. Very comfortable heel counter. No issues at all with rubbing. I think you could run for miles and miles and have no irritation on your Achilles tendon because of this heel counter. A little pull tab there, you know, that's kind of nice, especially when your hands are freezing. So pull tab to get the shoe, help get the shoe on your foot. And overall, the eyelet chain, again, the lockdown was solid. I just need to keep testing past 50 miles to see how the eyelet chain does. It looks like it's actually pretty high build quality now that I take a second look at it here in the studio. Overall, I'm pleased with the upper. Forgot to mention when I was talking about the drop, definitely falling into the high to maximalist category for the stack height. And yes, it is the Fresh Foam X midsole foam with a very surprisingly pleasant ride today. And the reason I say that is because I tested the Fresh Foam More in a store, I think it was last year, 2019. And even though, this is something to note, even though a shoe has a high stack height, that doesn't necessarily mean that the landing and the ride is gonna be soft under your feet, under your legs, okay? But this shoe actually does, okay? And let's do the durometer test. Like, it's got, for a trail shoe, I am pleasantly surprised, kind of like the Stinson from Hoka. Here we go. Now, this is just a beast. Like, you're not gonna find a more maximalist trail shoe on the market than this guy, the ATR6. But as far as the durometer test and just pushing the thumbs into that midsole, I'm gonna put these shoes into similar categories. However, this shoe has such a high stack height. If, you know, I guarantee some people are gonna feel unstable in this shoe, okay? Even though it does have a wide landing. Whereas this guy, it's not quite as high as stack height. I did not feel unstable at all for the midsole. And again, I only went 8 miles, I think total to around 8 miles. There it is on your screen. Actually, I'm trying to sync a watch inside the house, so I don't even know how far I went, but basically, I think over time, this midsole is gonna open up even more, okay? So very pleased overall with the midsole ride. It actually kind of shocked me, to be quite frank. Rubber on the outsole, there we go, the bottom of the shoe with some exposed fresh foam through the heel. And I guess to help with, you know, a softer landing, especially if you're a heel striker, kind of surprised me how that was exposed there through the heel, but it is what it is. And here's the reason that the score for the outsole is not a little bit higher. I'm not too impressed at this point with, and this hasn't popped up hardly ever, but with the lug pattern, the design of the shape of the lugs, okay? And I should have measured them. I'm gonna go with a guess of 3 millimeters at maybe 4 at the most as far as the lug depth there, but they're basically just a straight across the bottom of the shoe. I guess it would be laterally across the shoe, and I think they could absolutely add a little bit of configuration to those lugs to help with the grip on the ground. I felt it a little bit today. I'll keep testing. So that's that's just a little disappointing as far as the outsole goes for the lug pattern. For the fit and the comfort, the fit, it is feeling wide. So, there's a shoe called Salming, which is a company over in Europe. Oh gosh, Sweden is it? I think it might be Sweden. This shoe felt like the Salming shoe of 2019 that I tested. I didn't feel snug in the shoe at all. Plenty of room for a thicker sock if you're running in the winter time, and that means the midfoot and the toe box as well. Now, it wasn't like an ultra shoe by any means, but it wasn't snug at all as far as the fit of the shoe. Length of the shoe, I went true to size, no issues there. For the comfort, pretty good comfort score. Yeah, I'm very pleased actually. Shocked a little bit as far as the midsole goes, and a comfortable heel counter and collar. No major issues with comfort of the Fresh Foam More TR. For my positive and drawback, positive is the stack height. A higher stack height while keeping the weight of the shoe under 10 ounces in my size. And actually, let's do the comparison. I don't remember what this one weighs. Hold on one second, I can't resist. 10 and a half, so about a little over a half ounce heavier. So that is, again, good work, New Balance, keeping the weight of this shoe down. My drawback is the design and the shape of the lug patterns under the shoe. Okay, moving on to the durability prediction, 500 to 600. I'm going 500 to 600. I think it's got a pretty good lifespan. I guess the only concern for me, it wouldn't be midsole or outsole, would be the resilience of the upper. Because the upper is a little breathable through the toe box, if you're kicking roots, kicking rocks, you know, just running on really rugged trails, I could see this upper maybe wearing out eventually. So anyway, but I'm gonna stick with 500 to 600 for the durability prediction. How will I use this shoe moving forward? Daily training on the trails. Probably not 14er training, okay? More just daily training, and not buffed out trails, but locally in Denver, we've got Mount Falcon, we've got Deer Creek, we've got the trails outside of Boulder, those types of trails. So fairly tame trails, but absolutely a daily trainer. Who is it best for? I didn't think about this ahead of time. I'm gonna say, well, I mean, obviously cushion, obviously somebody that likes cushion and no ground contact feel. So even though I was going over some pretty good rocks today, I didn't feel like rocks poking the bottom of my feet at all. Okay, moving on to that price point. $165. Okay, and yes, it is available for pre-order down below. It's shipping in October. That's a little high for me, okay? Now, it's a trail shoe. As you probably know, trail shoes are always more expensive than road shoes because usually they have to put more material into the shoes in order to protect your feet from the rocks, the roots, all of that stuff. But I'd be much happier at 155, really 150, 149, of course, like right under that. 149 would be amazing. 165 is just getting up there a little bit, and I am gonna put on my screen, right on the screen right now, other shoes, and I don't even know what I'm gonna pick yet, but other shoes that I would put into the same category as far as stack height, and also to let you compare the prices. And again, they are available down below in the description. So there you go. That is my final early score, not my final score, final early score right there for you. A solid score, frankly. And again, I don't know. New Balance for me is more of a road shoe company, but I do think that this is a nice step in the right direction for New Balance with respect to their trail running shoe lineup. And yes, moving on here, speaking of trails and getting out there, and it's finally gonna be in the 80s, back in the 80s here in Denver. Question of the day, maybe you're hitting the trails this weekend. What are your running and or racing plans for this fine weekend? Make it a great one. I hope you have a good one out there. Thanks for being here in the studio. I think that's it. All right, everyone, we'll toss it to the New Balance. You know what? Actually, we'll toss it back to the last trail shoe that I did for a full review. It's probably this Stinson, actually. It might be this Stinson. We'll see. Right there. Seek beauty, work hard, and love each other. See you tomorrow.